Hey guys, it's Michael. I have a quick update for you on the second stimulus package. On Sunday on Face the Nation, a top economist, Mark Zandi, spoke about the second stimulus package, and he warned Congress that they have to do this one thing in order for us to see a recovery. Otherwise, we will definitely fall back into a recession. So in today's video, I'm gonna break down exactly what he said in this interview. We're first gonna go over what he said about the economy, and then after that, we're gonna get into specific aspects of the second stimulus package that he said must be included for us to not go back into a recession. But before we get started, I wanted to remind you guys to enter today's $50 free stock giveaway. All you need to do to be eligible is like the video down below, be subscribed to the channel, and comment down below the three stocks I mentioned at the end of today's video. If you don't want to enter, you can still go ahead and get two free stocks valued up to $1,400 when you download the Webull investing app using the link down below. That's where I trade all of my stocks. Anyways, let's jump right into it and let's get into what top economist Mark Zandi said in this Face the Nation interview yesterday morning. So the reporters started off by asking him about his take on unemployment report for June and what we learned from the data. And he goes on to say how almost 5 million jobs were created in June. It was 4.8 million jobs. He says that's on top of the 2.7 million jobs that were created in the May unemployment report. So he said we've gotten about a third of the jobs back that we've lost. He said how he knows people have been filing for unemployment every single week, and the unemployment rate is still hovering around 12%. But he explained how the unexpected, better than expected economic news that we received in this June unemployment report is a result of a very rapid increase in businesses reopening early in June. And he said, because they opened so fast, he says, now we are suffering for it because we're seeing the virus start to re-intensify and the pandemic is getting significantly worse. He said, right now in key states all across the country, states are starting to pull back and we're starting to see a number of increases all across these states, and we're seeing record highs in a number of states. And he goes on to say how all of this data and the resurgence in the number of virus cases was not reflected in any of the data in the June unemployment report, and that we're gonna see the result of these resurgence in the number of cases in the July unemployment report. He goes on to explain how he fears that the best economic news that we will receive was in this June unemployment report. And as we look towards July and moving forward, he says, the job statistics are going to be meaningfully worse than they were previously. He said that they are going to be much, much worse than they were in June. And he said right now the pandemic is a real issue because we're seeing exponential increases in the number of cases in a number of states across the country. Then he goes on to explain how right now, to make things even worse, he says these states that are seeing the worst numbers and these dramatic spikes in the number of cases are crucial and important to the US economy overall. He said these are very large economies. Texas, California, Florida, these are major states in the US that represent a large portion of the US economy. He says if you add up California, Texas, Florida, and now Arizona, he says now you're talking about one third of the entire US economy. He explained how New York was very hard hit, but right now with these three states alone, we're gonna represent more than one third of the US economy. And he explains how he does expect to see a pullback and start to see more restrictions put into place in businesses in those states. And he says it's not that just businesses are going to be directly affected, only businesses. He said it's not just restaurants, it's not just retailers. He said everyone will be affected because if businesses have to start to shut down again because virus increases, he says that will affect the entire economy. And essentially right now, all businesses are going to be on edge and be a little nervous about the uncertainty in the number of virus cases. Because if someone goes to their business and they get sick, well then all of these business owners can get sued and they're gonna be much more hesitant to reopen, which then leads to people not having jobs, which then makes it harder for people to spend money and for the economy to start growing again. So if these small businesses aren't able to open up or if they are forced to shut down, that's gonna have dramatic effects on the economy overall. And then finally, before he gets into the second stimulus package, he goes on to say how right now he thinks the prospects of going into a recession, back into a recession, are very, very high if we're to see the 100,000 cases every single day that Dr. Fauci predicted. He says, we've had one of the best quarters, the best past couple of months in the stock market, in the economy. We've seen tremendous growth, but if we see these cases rise, it is very likely that we will go back into a recession and we will see even more layoffs. Then the reporter goes on to ask him about the second stimulus package. And Mark Zandi goes on to warn Congress, warn the House of Representatives, warn all these top officials that they need to pass a second stimulus package. He responded by saying it is critical, absolutely critical, that we see a second stimulus package with direct stimulus measures to help Americans and directly support them. He said, you know, if Congress and the administration don't get it together in the next few weeks before the August recess, he said within that 15-day window when they get back from July recess and before the August recess, he says, I fear that we will go back into the recession because right now the economy needs a lot of help. He says, you can't be blinded by the June unemployment numbers and think, well, because those numbers look good, okay, well then the economy's doing well, because he said those numbers don't reflect what's going on right now and we need more support from the government. He explains how about one third of American workers right now are still struggling from either reduced hours, they're unemployed altogether, and if they don't receive additional help from the government with unemployment benefits, these $600 per week and $2,400 per month, if those aren't continued, and if we don't see another direct stimulus check, he says, then they're going to absolutely have no choice but to not pay their bills, cut spending, and the economy is really going to struggle. He said, if people don't receive these additional $2,400 per month or $600 per week payments, and if we don't get more direct payments in direct stimulus checks out, he says people are going to have no choice but to not pay their bills because they're not going to have enough money. And this will have effects on all aspects of the economy, and this will force us to go back into a recession. So he said Congress needs to make sure to expand and continue these unemployment benefits, and they also need to continue paying a direct stimulus check in the next stimulus round. And he says it needs to happen very quickly within the last couple weeks of July when they come back from the July recess. He explains how it's critical that Congress doesn't take the wrong message from what is going on right now with the June unemployment report. With virus cases increasing, it makes things even worse, and the government needs to pass more direct stimulus measures. Anyways, this is just a quick update for you from Chief Economist for Moody's Analytics, Mark Zandi, when he spoke with Face the Nation yesterday on Sunday. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Now let's get into the $50 free stock giveaway. All you need to do to be eligible is like the video down below, be subscribed to my channel, and comment down below these three stocks. The first stock is JD.com, and the stock ticker symbol is JD. The second stock for today's video is C Limited, and the stock ticker symbol is SE. And the third stock for today's video is going to be Dominion Energy, and the stock ticker symbol is D. So be sure to comment down below those three stocks. Anyways, don't forget to get your two free stocks valued up to $1,400 when you download the Webull investing app using the link down below. Join our Power of Finance Investors group if you're interested in the stock market investing and how to make money in general. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like the video down below, leave a comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.